Good morning, children. I hope all are fine. Today I am going to conduct video for grade 9, Sociology, Chapter 2, Socialization. Okay, in last chapter we already learned about the family. How many types of families are there and what is the importance of family and what are the functions of the joint and the nuclear family. So, you know that the family is very important for us, for everyone. And we all are a social being, we all are a human being, and because we live in a society, so that's why we are known as a social being. So what is the actual meaning of the socialization? It means it is a process of learning social behaviors, and to process of becoming social being is called a socialization. We are living in a society, so if we are not trying to interact with the society, with all the society's values and everything, we are not able to understand what is our society's rituals, values, beliefs, everything. So it is a socialization. So according to definition, if we can say that the socialization is a continuous process or social action, we start from a birth. So when a child born, from that time to till the death, the person is actually in the social behavior only, and he can understand, he can learn, he can just do according to society only. Now, what are the functions of socialization? There are some important functions of socialization which is very helpful to become a good citizen. Like first one is converts human beings into a social beings. Human beings who can think for that particular that own self only, the ourself only, but the social beings are thinking for the society, for the everyone's welfare, for every single person. Provides the scope of adapting, imitating and learning of many skills. When you are working in a group, when you are working in a together, that time you are able to understand so many things. Develop the social relationship and provide commitment and support to the social system. Helps the development of a personality and help the continuity of traditions. Those are the important functions. If we talk about help the develop the personality, if a person who really not interact to anyone, that is not able to do whatever the good advantages of the mind development and physical development, all these things. It is a requirement for daily basis that you have to talk, you have to share, you have to just interact with every single person or who are you are comfortable with it. So it is important to be a social being. The same thing that you have to give, transfer your traditions to one person to another. And it is a process, you know, it is a function in a socialization. Now, to understand better, there are, for understanding socialization, there are some agencies are there. Agencies means we all are a social being, you know that. In the social beings, where we are living, which are the first school we call, and how we can learn more things in according to which agency. So, there are 6 agencies in socialization. The first one is the family. If you talk about family, that you are in your mind, your image is coming like a mother, father, your brother, sister, grandfather, grandparents, uncle, aunt, cousins, everyone. According to joint family, those are the men. According to nuclear family, modern family, they are mother, father, brothers or siblings. That's it. So in those also, the some bond is there. When a child birth, after that time too, when it grows, education, the schooling and everything, they're just keeping support, love, concern, take care, everything to that particular child. And everyone is just really very curious about that, how the child will start learning, how the child will start walking, how the child will start talking. So this all are a fact to understand how important is a family for every single person. So the family is showing us to how to be, just share a love, concern, faith, belief, patience, cooperation and coordination with all the family members also, as well as outside people. Those are maybe our relatives, maybe our society member, maybe our friends, with those people also. The second is a peer group. Peer group here is a, you all are going in your schools, colleges. Okay, your parents is obviously elder than you. Your siblings or the younger brothers, they are younger than you. So those are your similar age group. These are known as a peer group. And mostly you found those similar age group in your schools, in your college, education, in your neighborhood areas. When you are with them, you are playing together, you are learning together, you are going to school together. Those are your friends. So this is a peer group. With peer group, what we learn that how to understand and how to help each other, how to coordinate each other, how to just support everyone. It is we can understand in a peer group. The next one is a religion. In India, we are really very follower of all the religions according to our every culture. So, in our society, the religion is the most very impactful agency in a socialization. Because according to religion, we are following our traditions, which is a really very impactful and the great values according to our grandparents, according to parents. And they are every day doing morning, evening, praising, pujas, everything. And which is the same thing they try to pass on us also, the same values. So that's why the religion is a very important agency in a socialization. According to religion, we can understand what are our values, what are our beliefs, what kind of beliefs our grandparents thinking and all these things. And with the religious purpose also, we can learn and more interest, we can know more interesting things. Now schooling. School, when you are 2.5 years old, from that time to when you pass grade, you are 10. From that time only your schooling is there. So it is a very long time when you just give a time to a school. Some persons they are changing the school, some persons they are just going in a countryside. So it is a very impactful place who is giving you more knowledge, concerns, patience, cooperation, coordination, and the most important thing, your grade 10 and everything. So in that only you can understand what is the behavior you can adjust with your teachers, with your classmates, with your other members, all this thing. In school, you can understand that what is the relationship between trying to understand as a teacher, as a student, as the classmates, all this thing. Because teacher is also teaching you not only about your subject material, is teaching you about your life material also. So it is a very great impact for in the some persons, they are just giving a very good knowledge according to teachers only. Next one is the mass media. In the present time is a modernization world. It means whatever you are doing, it is all according to modern equipments. Like in the present time, we are also teaching you as a modern equipment like a mobile phones and the so many, there are new advanced technology. So obviously it is a time of a modernization and the mass media. In the mass media also is the present time you can learn many more things. In the present time, you know that there are so many competitions going on according to worldwide areas. And all those competitions, you can participate, you can learn, and you can just try to give your more knowledge according to all these mass media processes. Now, the next one is a neighborhood. When we are living in any area, like whatever area where you are living, you saw that some neighborhood places are there, or some neighbors are there, which every evening, morning, they are trying to wish you, they are trying to understand you, maybe they are trying to some help for you. So those are the people who can just give you a concern about your or maybe your family and just try to help in your need time. So those are in our neighborhoods, and according to neighborhoods, we can better learn to how to cooperate in some difficult situation or with some different type of people. Because it is not compulsory that your relatives are only on your neighborhood. Maybe the people is from different states, they are only your neighborhood. So you can understand, better understand to a different geographical condition according to those particular places, maybe the rituals, maybe the cultures and everything. Now, the next topic is gender and socialization. Okay, here we talk about gender. It means in our past society, there are such kind of discrimination happen. Like the girl child is not important, but the boy child is important. There are some strict real rules for the girls, like they are not go out for the education, they are not go out for the job, they are not go out for any purpose. But the same kind of that, for the boys, there are all the freedoms are there. So this kind of situation in the past time is there. But in the present time, according to education, the day by day, the things are changed. And not only change, they are developing. They are just giving a more advantages and the things to the girls and the boys as well. In the present time, in every field, we saw that there are girls who are also doing the same kind of things and work or earning the same kind of amount whatever the boys are earning. And in every field, like it doesn't matter about the science, technology, teaching, mass media, even armies also in the present time, all over in the politics also, all over we saw the girls are there. And they are just giving a great variety of contribution for our national income, for our per capita income, and for our advanced technologies also. So this is a chapter about socialization. In this chapter, the main thing is that we all are human beings, but according to society and the some agency, we are trying to being a social being. And when we are social being, it means we can coordinate, we can concern, and when the we can do a cooperation and the work together. So now I'm going to end my session. Thank you.